It was not long ago that the words, "Miles to go before I sleep," resonated in the school auditorium as our founder principal spoke about his future plans for the growth of the school. Those miles have been covered. Sir has breathed his last and is in his eternal sleep, having given to the world his final project, having fulfilled his dream of housing the entire school in the pristine Palada campus. Good evening to all present today and welcome to the 44th Founders Day program commemorating our founder principal, late Dr. P.C. Thomas.
It is my honor to present the profile of this year's chief guest for the Founders Day celebrations, retired Justice Shri P. Sadasivam, the former Chief Justice of India and former Governor of Kerala. Hailing from an agricultural family in Erode district of Tamil Nadu, Shri Justice P. Sadasivam graduated from the Government Law College, Madras in 1973. After having served as an advocate, special government pleader and legal advisor to several public organizations, he was appointed as a permanent judge of the Madras High Court on 8th January 1996. While serving as judge of the Punjab and Haryana High Court, he was elevated to the post of judge of the Supreme Court on 21st August 2007. He was sworn in as the 40th Chief Justice of India on 19th July 2013, a position he held till 26th April 2014. Shri Justice Sadasivam's commitment to democracy and national causes is evident in many path-breaking judgments like the Reliance Gas judgment, where he observed that, I quote, "The national assets belong to the people and should be explored through the public sector," I unquote. His directives to the union and state governments to prohibit manual scavenging and to grant rupees 10 lakh as compensation to the families of those who died in the sewers since 1993 shows his concern for the downtrodden. Justice Sadasivam is also credited with the judgments that led to the implementation of reservation for the disabled and the introduction of electoral reforms like NOTA and paper trail. Along with Justice B.S. Chauhan, he delivered the judgment in the Mumbai Blasts case, the biggest case heard in the history of Supreme Court, which sent actor Sanjay Dutt and many others to prison. His decision in the Rajiv Gandhi assassination accused case on the unexplained and unreasonable delay in disposal of mercy petitions by the president, leading to commutation of death sentence into life term, was also noted nationwide. Shri Sadasivam, who assumed office as the Governor of Kerala on 5th September 2014, has pioneered a quality improvement drive in higher education by instituting the Chancellor's Award for the best university in the state. His keen interest in agriculture, concern for the welfare of farmers, and commitment to social justice and democratic values have made him a people's governor. Shri Sadasivam is married to Srimati Saraswati and they have two sons.
We begin the 44th Founders Day program with a prayer written by our founder principal, late Dr. P.C. Thomas. It will be read by Shauryaveer Malik of grade 9.
Please bow your heads. O dear good shepherd, my God, my light, be with me always, day and night. Teach me to do what's good and right, and always keep me within thy sight. Amen.
The school song and the school prayer song will be led by the middle school choir. The school song, "Hail Good Shepherd," our alma mater.
Hail, good shepherd, our alma mater.
Lord's my shepherd.
Aditi Bishaka Das of grade 7 will lead the school in prayer.
Let us pray. O dear Good Shepherd, make our school a home away from our home. Make us always feel that we all belong to a family and that the teachers are like our parents. We believe that you speak through them when we listen to them. Give more wisdom to all concerned with us, so that they may guide us always on the right path. Make us know your presence and power by rewarding and punishing us. Let us not become proud when we are rewarded, and let us not become humiliated when you punish us for our mistakes. Give us enough strength to forget and forgive as you forgive us our sins. We thank you for the showers of blessings on this school, for its growth and progress into a big and a good school. Give us everything to make our lives in this school a happy one. This we ask for your love's sake. Amen.
We will now have a presentation on the life and achievements of our founder principal, late Dr. P.C. Thomas.
Like on every Founders Day before today, on the 44th Founders Day of Good Shepherd International School, we celebrate the birth anniversary of Dr. P.C. Thomas, who founded the school along with his wife, Mrs. Elsema Thomas. Sir, generations of students and teachers miss your presence, but your legacy shines on.
Dr. Thomas, to many of us, was simply a strict disciplinarian. But at his heart, he was a relentless leader. He believed that quality education wasn't simply about setting children on the right path, but was about empowering them to believe that they could create paths for themselves. And that's why I and scores of other children are grateful to Dr. Thomas. We are grateful to him for giving us a voice, for giving us confidence.
Today, we celebrate a life that has molded many lives nationally and internationally. You are missed, but I will talk about you only in the present tense, as your legacy is omnipresent in every student and within the very soul of the institution which you built along with ma'am.
I recollect what Mahathre had mentioned during a school assembly. We have one privilege that the future would never have. We could walk with the founder, see him during our time, work with him hand in hand, and experience the visionary in our lifetime, who could conceive an idea and show what the power of human potential behind an idea is to turn that idea into reality.
The greatest achievement, according to me, is this exquisite seat of learning which he and ma'am have created together and contributed to society.
Whenever one had an appointment with him, you automatically spruced up and were punctual to the dot. As he always said, time wasted can never come back. My mentor in Rotary, he taught me that a life without purpose has no meaning, and that we must always, as privileged people, look after those who are less privileged.
Dr. Thomas believed in imparting to the young men and women all-round education that places emphasis on academic learning and also places importance on character building and developing leadership qualities.
Over the course of 2 years, I had the rare privilege of listening to the stories of his childhood, his vivid recollections of his time at Kerala, his attention to detail in the reminiscences of how he built this empire, and how his eyes lit up when he spoke of how he put his grand dream together, brick by brick. The deep empathy he carried for the people who worked with him, alongside him, is a big lesson that I have carried forth in my own leadership initiatives.
He truly is an example of perfection, possible thinking, and progress. His attention to detail is noteworthy as a leader, organizer, and a human being.
Thank you.
Sir never thought of man and he as two different individuals. To him, they were one, united for a common cause. If Good Shepherds is the brainchild of Sir, then it is the child of man's heart. And that is how he always spoke of it to me.
Happy birthday, Daddy. I hope you're happy in your new home. I just wanted to say thank you on behalf of the Good Shepherd community for what you've done for all of us. And I hope you continue to watch over us as you've always done, helping us, guiding us throughout our lives. You've always been our Good Shepherd, and we've always been your flock. So we need you now more than ever. So as a birthday gift, I just wanted to say, you've been a great granddad, and you've been a great father, and you've been a great teacher. So continue to be there for us, because that's all we can ask from you.
For all of you, Dr. P.C. Thomas was a visionary, a leader, a teacher, a man who pursued excellence relentlessly. For me, he was my husband and my life partner, the father of my children and the man with whom I went on a long journey of discovery, hard work, perseverance, and immense gratitude for the last 50 years, in every moment of our life together. I have looked up to him as my husband and thanked my parents and the God Almighty for the man that he was. I miss his leadership in our family. I miss his companionship. I miss his larger than life presence, and will continue to miss him every day of my life. Along with our children and the Good Shepherd family, I intend to keep his spirit alive by working towards fulfilling his vision of excellence in education. This is the best way we can honor his memory forever.
President Mr. Jacob Thomas will now address the students, staff, parents, and guests.
Good evening to one and all of you. It is truly an honor to welcome you to the 44th Founders Day of the Good Shepherd International School and the birth anniversary of my late father and founder of the school, Dr. P.C. Thomas, whom we all miss dearly today on this occasion. A very warm welcome to our esteemed chief guest, Sri Justice P. Sadasivam, the former Chief Justice of India and Governor of Kerala. Thank you, sir, for gracing us with your presence today. Welcome to our Chairman of the Board, retired IAS officer and former Chairman of Madras Port Trust, and Industry Secretary to the Government of Tamil Nadu, Mr. D. Selvaraj, and to the members of the Board of Governors. And welcome to the co-founder and Senior Vice President, Mrs. Ethelma Thomas, to our new principal, Mrs. Sheila Alexander, and to our students, staff, and all of you who are able to join us today from around the world. On the day of his birth, it is my greatest honor to talk to you a little about my father. If there is one word I could use to describe him, it is discipline. And I have come to learn that discipline is one of the most vital ingredients towards achieving any kind of success in one's life. My father was a man determined to make his mark in everything he set out to do. And his most noteworthy achievement remains the Good Shepherd International School. This great institution that he and my mother envisioned, founded and nurtured since 1977. From very simple beginnings, they partnered to create an all-encompassing residential school that is now considered to be on par with the best in the world. My father imagined a global knowledge village, an environment in which to provide children with the opportunities to pursue many passions and to hone the skills relevant in a world that is vastly more advanced than the one we know. Looking at the impact from the prevailing pandemic, it is evident that it has acted as a catalyst, accelerating many of the many profound trends to take shape in modern times. As many of you have experienced online classes for the first time in your lives, so have countless others who have had to learn to work remotely because of the restrictions that have been imposed on all of us. These rapid changes will force us to further change the way we live, work, explore, and most importantly, learn. As the Chinese say, may we live in interesting times. And I find it certainly describes where we are at this pivotal moment in our history. Our knowledge of the world as we live in today gives us the new ability to more accurately map out our future. For example, we can already see how learning will need to evolve and adapt to the ambitions and dreams of today's youth for their future. It is vastly different from what my generation imagined for our lives. What new skills will they need to thrive in this bright future? How will they go about gaining the knowledge and insights to enrich their lives? What resources will become more relevant in this endeavor? The opportunities are boundless and exciting, and I see a place for GSIS to be at the forefront of how our students will learn and develop the competencies to thrive in this new world. GSIS is today an educational platform on which new frontiers can be created and fostered, readying our students to make their mark in this forthcoming world. This platform is also a continuous journey towards excellence, inspired by the vision and drive of my father. In spite of his physical ailments these past few years, he persisted in his mission to guide and nurture the development of the school by setting higher standards and encouraging innovation in everything we do. Education is a lifelong pursuit, and my father spent his entire life fostering an environment built around the development of a holistic and complete education for all who came to him as his students. Let me leave you with these words from Adam Smith, the great economist and author of the book, Wealth of Nations. The real price of everything, what everything really costs to the man who wants to acquire it, is the toil and trouble of acquiring it. My father toiled every day of his life to bring his dreams to fruition, and I can say with confidence that he is resting peacefully today knowing that he did. Thank you and God bless.
The Ant-Man theme is considered the best music for a comic book that was ever written. It was composed by Christoph Beck and arranged by Michael Brown. Its fine, stylish music and effervescence accord it a captivating quality. Impressively, Christoph Beck manages to make it sound like a throwback, but also firmly keeps it modern and relevant. Theme from Ant-Man will be performed by the Chamber Orchestra of Good Shepherd International School. Thank you. Paul McCartney, the co-vocalist and bassist of the Beatles, wrote the song Let It Be. It was inspired by his mother, Mary, who passed away when he was 14. Since Let It Be was the Beatles' last album, it made an appropriate statement about leaving problems behind and moving on in life. According to McCartney, this is a very positive song owing to its inspiration. One night, he was paranoid and anxious. He had a dream in which he saw his mother, who had been dead for about 10 years. She came to him in his time of trouble, speaking words of wisdom that brought him much peace when he needed it. It was the sweet dream that got him to write the song. Let It Be will now be performed by the middle school choir.
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be.
The welcome address will be delivered by the principal, Mrs. Sheila Alexander.
Honorable Justice P. Sadashivam, former Chief Justice of India and Governor of Kerala, co-founder and the Senior Vice President, Mrs. Elsima Thomas, President, Mr. Jacob Thomas, Chairman of the Board of Governors, Mr. V. Selvaraj, members of the Board of Governors, parents, guardians, old shepherdians, students, members of the faculty, ladies and gentlemen. Founders Day is a special occasion as it is the birthday of our founder principal, Dr. P.C. Thomas. This is the first time in the history of Good Shepherd International School we are celebrating the Founders Day without our founder principal. We need to celebrate what the founder had envisioned for Good Shepherd International School. With great humility, we as a school community will continue creating global citizens for a changing world. The Founders Day is a moment that allows us to consider what our founders' aspirations have been. For the past 44 years, reflect on the 44 years of greatness, grit, and growth. Celebrate all that we have achieved together and aspire yet again, as success is never final. I extend a very warm welcome to the 44th Founders Day celebrations. We are greatly honored to have Honorable Justice Sadashivam as a chief guest for this special occasion. Thank you, sir, for kindly consenting to our request. Born on 27th April 1949, and enrolled as an advocate in July 1973, Justice Sadashivam hails from Tamil Nadu. He is from a family of agriculturalists and is not only the first graduate in his family but also the first graduate in law. As a member of the Supreme Court, he has delivered or been on the bench for many landmark decisions. He was appointed a permanent judge of the Madras High Court in January 1996. In 2007, he moved to the Punjab and Haryana High Court. Honorable Justice Sadashivam was elevated to the Supreme Court in August 2007. He was sworn in as the 40th Chief Justice of India on 19 July 2013 and retired on 26 April 2014. He is the first judge from Tamil Nadu to become the Chief Justice of India. On retirement from his judicial career, Justice Sadashivam was appointed as the 21st Governor of Kerala from September 2014 to September 2019. He has pioneered a quality improvement drive in higher education by instituting the Chancellor's Award for the best university in Kerala. Sri Justice Sadashivam is married to Srimati Saraswati and has two sons. Sir, I extend a very warm welcome to you on behalf of Good Shepherd International School. I also welcome the Chairman, the Board of Governors, parents, guardians, old shepherdians, students, staff and well-wishers to the 44th Founders Day celebrations. Thank you.
Thank you, Sheila Miss. Mr. V. Selvaraj, IAS, Chairman, Board of Governors of Good Shepherd International School, will address all present today.
15th of October is the Founders Day of the Good Shepherd International School. The school celebrates it with all its best actions brought out during this day by way of speeches, songs, performances, and invariably this day used to be addressed by a chief guest of national eminence. It is the Founders Day, remembering the founder, the legendary Dr. P.C. Thomas. I was the district collector of Nilgiris 45 years ago, in 1974-75 when I joined. Also was the year when I came to know Dr. P.C. Thomas and his family members. And this association continued till Dr. Thomas passing away, and it continues even to this day with all my associations with the school and the governing body, namely the Board of Governors. Dr. B.C. Thomas was a man of very high qualities of head and heart. He not only preached for others, but practiced all that he was preaching himself. He was not only a dreamer, but he converted all his dreams into reality. A very rare genius indeed. And he has left behind a legacy, namely the great institution of the Good Shepherd International School. The school was set up, and I am associated with that right from day one. It was set up in Nilgiris a place already known for good schools, imparting lessons to the young citizens of this country. At the beginning of the Good Shepherd School marked a very, very remarkable change in the Nilgiri's landscape, that it brought in under one roof people coming from different parts of India and different parts of the world. Parents entrusting their children in the care of Dr. P.C. Thomas and his admirable wife, Mrs. Elsama Thomas, and all the children in the school who were in the campus, treated the campus and the life in the campus as a home away from home. Not only in the field of education, but in the field of socio-economic progress of the backward region of Nilgiris, the founding of the school catered to employment of more than 1,000 people, all educated, highly educated, skilled, direct employment as well as indirect employment, and brought under one roof some of the most educated teachers, some of the most brilliant academicians known for their dedication to school education. And this tradition has been continued, and the indications are very clear, abundantly clear, that even during this period of pandemic, COVID-19, the school ensured the safety of all the children and gave tremendous confidence to the parents that their children are in the best hands to be looked after. Also on the academic side, they pursued all the educational projects online, making use of the latest tools in the information technology, left no stone unturned in achieving the mission and the vision of the founder, Dr. P.C. Thomas.
Thank you, sir. We next have the address by the chief guest, Sri Justice P. Sadasivam.
Srimadi Elsama Thomas, Managing Trustee and Senior Vice President of Good Shepherd International School, Ooty, members of governing body, respected faculty members, other staff members, parents, and my dear students. I am happy to participate Founders Day celebrations, which is also the birthday of Dr. P.C. Thomas, on 15th October 2020. I convey my best wishes to all students of this prestigious Good Shepherd International School, Ooty. It is undoubtedly one of the India's best co-educational schools. The school embraces all cultures and endeavors to promote a constant and healthy growth in the academic and extracurricular activities. I am happy to note that the school has virtually all basic requirements, and there is invariably an effort to blend tradition with modernity in a truly international sense. It is also relevant to mention here that according to Education World India School Ranking for 2019 and 20, Good Shepherd International School is ranked number 1 International Residential School in Tamil Nadu and number 2 in India for the year 2019. I congratulate the management, particularly Madam Thomas and all faculty members, staff and my dear students for this achievement. Dear students, I would like to stress on two aspects. One is the will to succeed. Second, the skill to achieve success. One is will to succeed. The other one is skill to achieve success. You should ever be grateful to your teachers for equipping you with the confidence that is inevitable to go up in your life. I have always felt that it is not the beauty and grandeur of faculty buildings or the number of disciplines being taught that determine the standard and dignity of any institution or even university. When the students leave the portals of their mother institution, they should have learned the fundamentals of decent behavior and basic norms of humanity. This aspect is what Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, our former President of India, has termed as the spark and spirit of education. I take this as an occasion to share few values with you, with your young minds, but it would not be a lecture of advice. There are three values which all of you should cherish and possess in life to be able to succeed. I will elaborate one by one. Firstly, do what your heart desires. Secondly, be grateful to those people who were behind you in all odd times. The last but not the least, constantly challenge yourself. Let me elaborate a little on these three values by infusing my own experience. First, do what your heart desires. No money, no brand name, not even the fame that you have achieved will satisfy you when you reach my age. Now I am 72. I know it is too early to talk about the tail end of your career, but time just flies. It is always good to be prepared. Time is limited. So don't waste it living with the wavelengths of others' observations. You have to really trust something inside yourself. Don't let the noise of others' opinions shadow your own inner voice, heart and intuition. Follow your passion and stay true to yourself. Remember, my dear youngsters, the choice of profession or career must stem from idealism, a cherished dream or passion, and not made keeping in mind which job or profession will be more lucrative. Friends, second advice, eternally be grateful to those people who were behind you in all odd times. I was raised on a country sunshine by farmer parents who made incredible sacrifices to send me even to school. My wife stood by my side from my days of studying law. Since I joined law course only after my marriage, to the days of my judging, and even till today, there have been lot of friends who have supported me through ups and downs. Never allow any decision of yours to any corner of time to be swayed by the factor of money or fear. The third one, challenge yourself. Success is built on the rocks of challenges. Without a challenge, you can't come up in your life. That is my own experience. If you aspire to be successful, then you will have to face your own tests and challenges in the years to come. Challenge yourself. Take some risk in your life. Focusing your life solely on making money shows a dearth of ambition. Money is not the only criteria. It asks too little of yourself, and it will leave you unfulfilled. Making your mark on the world is very hard. It takes patience, it takes commitment, and it comes with plenty of failures along the way. Aptly said by the great humanist Abraham Lincoln, always, I quote, always bear in mind that your own resolution to succeed is more important than any other thing, unquote. So my beloved students, I urge you to take a vow today that you will improve your willpower every day by challenging yourself to accomplish a difficult task. Today, I would like to emphasize on the role of students in India's vision. Students are often referred as invaluable investment for future. They are, on every count, the molders of better tomorrow. That is why eminent educationalists and academicians insist on giving them a 100% foolproof coaching and training on whatever discipline they opt for. Friends, the progress of any country, big or small, depends primarily on the standard of education that is being imparted at all levels. Whatever the subject, be it art, science, literature, law, or technology, one has to be sound, grounding on it. And that is precisely what every institute or training center has to ensure at the fundamental phase of each discipline. All educational institutions should aim at transforming students into resourceful young men and women, equipping them with essential qualities of an enlightened existence. In fact, what distinguishes a learned man from unfinished in his capacity to face the crucial crisis of life, the lifetime quality of his response and behavior in relation to his fellow beings, rich as well as poor. My dear students, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, our former president and one of the most illustrious sons of India, was a true teacher to the last moment of his legendary life. He always held the student community close to his heart. The last function Dr. Kalam attended was an address to the students at Shillong, which is in northeast part of our country. Known all over the world as the Missile Man of India, his words inspired the students and ignited their young minds. He urged the students to dream big and aim high, and asserted that their dreams would one day blossom into reality. His inspiring speeches focused on the positive side of action, initiating them to break barriers and forge ahead. When I completed my schooling, dear students, I studied only in government high school in Erode district. I wanted to become a doctor, but I was unsuccessful in acquiring a seat through merit. So I pursued my graduation in Bachelor of Arts, that is Economics. Thereafter, I got married. It was in my wedding reception that I was advised by a well-wisher that I should do law and make lawyering my profession. As I did my schooling in Tamil language, Tamil medium, in a government school, I studied English newspaper, I studied English language by reading daily English newspapers. Then the life took many turns, of which I am grateful to my family, who always held by my side. I was considered for the judgeship of the High Court of Madras at the young age of 46, and after 10 years serving as a judge of the Madras High Court, I was transferred to Punjab and Haryana High Court at Chandigarh, later to Supreme Court of India. I occupied the office of Chief Justice of India during 2013 and 2014, only one from Tamil Nadu from 1950 till this day, and retired as 40th Chief Justice of India on 26th April 2014. Later, I was appointed as Governor of a state of Kerala, assumed office on 5th September 2014 and demitted the office of governorship on 5th September 2019 after completing full term of 5 years. I never would have guessed this could happen when I was sitting in your seat. So, stay open to new ideas and new prospects as you move in life. The most significant achievements in life often come from unanticipated opportunities. Your only task is to grab that opportunity and to give your best by doing hard work. My dear young friends, as a person hailing from judiciary and occupied the highest position in judiciary as Chief Justice of India, I request all of you to learn and understand some of the relevant and important provisions of our Constitution of India, which was enacted on 26th November 1949. You must know preamble in the Constitution, which speaks about justice, liberty, equality, fraternity, and unity, as well as integrity of our nation. The other important provisions are fundamental rights, fundamental duties, free press, freedom to speak and write, free movement throughout India, Kashmir to Kanyakumari, Ahmedabad to Shillong, right to criticize government if they go wrong, independent judiciary, no arrest without assigning adequate reasons, etc. Our Constitution protects both male and female equally, equal rights to women. Everyone must be aware of free legal aid, legal literacy, legal awareness, Lok Adalat, etc. Friends, my dear students, it is my duty to inform that now our entire nation is struggling to come out from COVID 2019, that is coronavirus. All of us have to strictly adhere and follow all the instructions of both center and state governments, wearing of mask, maintaining social distancing, provision for thermal scanning and use of hand wash or sanitation will be mandatory. Very soon we will come out from this agony. Finally, my dear students, purity, patience and perseverance are three essentials to success, and above all, have patience in all your undertakings. Congratulations and God bless you. May you see all the heights of success in your career and in your personal life. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you very much, sir. The expression of gratitude will now be conveyed by Mrs. Elsema Thomas, the Senior Vice President.
Good evening, everybody. Chief guest of today's function, Honorable Justice P. Sadashivam, former Justice of India and former Governor of Kerala, Chairman and Board of Governors of Good Shepherd International School, parents and guardians, old shepherdians, staff members, and my dear students. In the history of the school, this is the first Founders Day program we are celebrating without the founder, late Dr. P.C. Thomas. We as a school community should carry forward the legacy and vision the founders have for Good Shepherd International School. The Founders Day program is conducted in different way, that is, virtually due to the ongoing pandemic. I thank Honorable Justice Sadashivam for his motivating and thought-provoking speech. Thank you, sir, for taking your time off and for speaking to the school community. I thank Mr. Selvaraj, IAS, Chairman of the Board of Governors, for the kind words he has spoken about my husband, Dr. B.C. Thomas. I thank the other members of the board for their continued support and guidance. We have been working more than normal during this difficult times, and as explained in our calendar for the year 2020, we have conducted all programs and events functions remotely. I wanted to thank you all for your continued help and assistance in making this happen. I appreciate the kind cooperation from the parents, students, and teachers in successfully continuing with our education in a different form. The program went off very well, and I must thank the music and dance departments for coordinating the choir, music, and dance, and for successfully conducting this program virtually. It is a challenging task as all of us are in different parts of the country and the world. I thank all the students who took part in the program and gave their best. I also thank the compliment the Academic Council members for their support to make this program a success. I would like to thank the principal, Mrs. Sheila Alexander, for leading the academic team in a professional way with the assistance of our coordinators. I also thank our IT team for their support. President Jacob has been working remotely in place of his dad. Now I would like to congratulate the recipients of the Elsama Thomas Gold Medal for their outstanding achievement in their board exams. The recipients are V.P. Lakshit, ISE Science; R.R. Varshida, ISE Commerce; Sri Niket Krishnan, IB. The following are the students who have received the scholarship for their excellent performance in the grade 10 board exams and are continuing in grade 11 in GSIS. The names are Rishika, Himanshu Sapariwala, Linga Prabhu, Akshida Muthukumar, Ravina Jayvant Patil, Kanupriya Vingal Chawla, Harshul Ashish Amin, Nitya Nilesh Danani, Meet Dabaria. I wish the students all the very best in their future endeavors. I once again thank everyone who are watching this program, and I request you all to stay safe. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. We continue with the remaining programs. Yesterday's Dream is a 1968 single recorded by the Four Tops for the Motown label. The song was at number 31 on Billboard's best-selling soul singles and number 23 in the UK. The song tells us that children are an important part of our future, and we as adults have the responsibility to help them, teach them, and guide them in the right direction. Yesterday's Dream by the Junior School Choir.
the Indian Music Department will now present a delightful mixture of traditional and modern music. The presentation commences with a Swara Prastara, which is an exploration of note patterns. Composed in Raga Kalyani set to Adi Tala, it is a beautiful fusion of both Carnatic and Western music. This will be followed by the cover version of a Bollywood song from the 1997 movie Border, directed by J.P. Datta. The lyrics of the song are by Javed Akhtar and the music for the song has been composed by Anu Malik. Enjoy this mixture of traditional and modern music.
The next program is a Jugalbandi dance by students of high school and high secondary. It is a supreme art of the teacher to awaken joy in creative expression and knowledge, said Albert Einstein. Dr. P.C. Thomas always recognized the spark in every child and encouraged them to uphold their rich culture and give their best. Through this Indian classical dance, Jugalbandi, a fusion of Bharatanatyam and Kathak, we pay our tribute to our guru, the great teacher, our principal, late Dr. P.C. Thomas.
Guru Sakshat tajam
tagada janu tajam
tagada janu tajam
tagada janu tadirana tanadirana di
nadratani tajam tagada janu tajam
tagada janu tajam tagada janu tadirana tanadirana di tirana dilana tadirana tanadirana di
గణం జగీ పిట తగణ ప్రభు తుమ్మ కిట పిట తగ తగీ జను రగణం జగీ పిట తగణ ఆన ధంధాన సుగత దివే పంద ధిడ ధిడ తర్రం తగురం తాన ధంధాన సుగత దివే పంద ధిడ ధిడ తర్రం తగురం నిత్త దంగు తక సద్యోజాత త్రిఫలం దిహి వామదేవ కాహతయుం తత్పురుష ఐంధనం అఘోర ధిడ ధిడ ఈశాన నమో నమః శివాయ నమో నమః శివాయ నమో నమః శివాయ శివాయ
Somebody That I Used to Know is a song written by the Belgian-Australian singer-songwriter Gautier featuring New Zealand singer Kimbra. It is a mid-tempo ballad and it samples Louise Bonfa's instrumental Seville from his 1967 album Louise Bonfa Plays Great Songs as an opening refrain with a sparsely recurring motif in other parts of the song. The song is about the emotional turmoil after a broken relationship. In 2013, the song won 2 Grammy Awards for the Best Pop Duo or Group Performance and Record of the Year. Here is an instrumental rendition of the song by the guitar ensemble of Good Shepherd International School.
Next comes a medley of 2 songs sung as a duet. Hero by Mariah Carey and Heaven Was Needing a Hero by Joe D. Messina. We dedicate the song to late Dr. P.C. Thomas, who dreamed big, believed in his dreams, and worked towards it. We all enjoy the fruit of his vision today. He walked this earth as a hero, and we know he has carried his strength and goodness into heaven above. This duet will be presented by Denise D'Souza and Jeffin Verghese Thomas.
There's a hero, if you look inside your heart, you don't have to be afraid of what you are. There's an answer, if you reach into your soul, and the sorrow that you know will melt away. Comes along with the strength to carry on, and you cast your fears aside, and you know you can't survive. So when you feel like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong, and you'll finally see the truth that a hero lies.
Heaven was needing a hero, somebody just like you. Brave enough to stand up for what you believe and follow it through. When I try to make it make sense in my mind, the only conclusion I come to is that heaven was needing a hero.
And then a hero comes along with the strength to carry. And you cast your fears aside, and you know you can't survive. So when you feel like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong, and you'll finally see the truth that a hero lies in.
The school choir will now present the song Happy. This song is meant to lift one's spirits. No matter how tough the times in our lives are, our minds should be strong enough to be positive and face the world with a smile. Feel free to clap, tap, and sing along. Happy by the school choir.
Might seem crazy what I'm about to say. Sunshine, she's here, you can take a break. I'm a hot air balloon that can go to space with the air like I don't care, baby, by the way. Not alone if you feel like a room without a roof. If you feel like happiness is the truth, clap along if you know what happiness is to you. Clap along if you feel like that's what you wanna do. You can't
We conclude the 44th Founders Day program with the school anthem. Guests, staff and students for your presence and support. Thank you once again.